you, Beatriz, thank you so much for your invitation. And as you mentioned before, we've been working together the last 5 years, you and all people from the University of Basque Country, like Pilar González and Antoine Mar present here. I want to mention them as well. And when you provided us, when you invited us to present the topic of culture, data, and digitalization in this book workshop, I propose to speak about towards a better understanding of the cognitive destination image of the Basque Country based on the analysis of user-generated content. This is quite different approach from the previous ones. The professor Antoine Chauvin, they speak more about reality mining. And we are going to speak more about analysis of user-generated content. And this work has much to do with culture, data, and digitalization. I'll try to explain how. First, data. Which is the type of data we are taking into account in this context? The data will be opinions and experiences as means of user-generated content. And why? Because this type of data is really important. This type of data are key factors influencing our behavior. And there are several studies and research works that demonstrate that when we have to make a decision, we seek the opinions of others. And the consumers no longer rely exclusively on official sources, but they consume comments based on experience. And this way, they may obtain a more complete image of the destination. So the data we are going to focus on are user-generated contents, opinions, and experiences. And where is this data posted? This data is mainly posted in social networks. And we know that this phenomenon, with the explosion of Web 2.0, users' opinion gains weight against traditional marketing techniques. The development of these networks is well studied, and we know that these social networks are affecting very directly to brands and e-commerce. They are changing the dynamics of the entire sector of travel and tourism. 65% of active Facebook accounts follow a brand. And the users of internet, 85% of users, they use Facebook, and 32% of users use Twitter. And these social networks is really important for the study of the destination, for the study of the behavior of the tourist and the visitor, because they support the complete cycle of tourism: inspiration, planning, booking, stay, and content, the pre, the during, and the post visit. And in this study, we want to take advantage of this type of source because we know that there is a big gap in one topic, and it's the destination image. We think that this data source may be a valuable source to get insights about the image of the destination. We can use the analysis of the discourses on the web to gain knowledge about how destination is perceived, to gain knowledge about motivations and the underlying discourses. But we have to take also into account that there is not a universally accepted and validated model, destination image model. So to move forward, we have to choose one. And in this case, our reference model will be the one proposed by Professor Gomez et al. In 2013. So, which is the aim of this presentation, this research work? Our aim is to model the cognitive destination image of the Basque Country by visitors, having as reference the conceptual model proposed by Gomez et al. And based on data collected from social media, destination sites, general social networks, travel blogs, views. This should be works. And to achieve this goal, this aim, we use, this work involves automatic semantic identification of opinions using technologies, text mining tool adapted to a specific domain, that is the tourism destination, and this tool was being developed jointly by Mondragon University and Pictorum. When we started to do this work, we started with a literature review. And there are many definitions of destination image. But we can say that destination image is an individual's overall perception or total set of impressions of a place. And the research regarding the destination image has been conducted since the early 70s with different and several assessment methods. First of all, structured surveys, human responded. After that, mixed methods, taking into account to approach textual data from blogs and websites. So it's a quite complex topic, because although there has been so many years doing this type of research, we have not an universally accepted method, and methods for assessment are many and in from different ways. But there are some consensus, and one of them is that most tourism scholars agree that the destination image holds at least two distinctive components. One is the cognitive, and the other one is the affective. The cognitive means to knowledge and beliefs, and the affective is about feelings and so on. And there are other components that are being taken into account by other scholars and researchers. In this work, we will focus just in the cognitive aspect of the destination image, because we wanted to keep it as simple as possible, and the measurement of the user-generated content and the results we can get about the discourses, we wanted to be very clear and easy to assess. In our model, from the cognitive perspective, Gomez et al. Proposed a destination image based on four dimensions: natural and cultural resources, structures, socioeconomic environment, and social atmosphere constraints. And the literature considers, this is quite important to us, because it considers that the amount and variety of secondary data may contribute significantly to the formation of the image. So there are several research works taking using these secondary data sources, like Flickr, a social network, like destination websites, and other qualitative studies that they analyze and examine travel logs. So the methodology we follow in this work is composed of three steps. First of all, we have to define and select the relevant data. We need to extract categories from the selected data sources, and we need to transform the categories into a model. So at the beginning, we start defining and selecting just relevant data. This work is, we can define as a qualitative work, because a prior analysis was carried out, taking into account the quality and the quantity of the data from a double perspective: the projected image by the GMO and the perceived image by the visitor. And we considered these channels, the TripAdvisor, that is a well-known reviewer site, and the quantity of the comments were about 50,000 posts. And this is from October 2010 to April 2013. The other data source was the Minube. This is a social network of travel experiences with about 4,000 experiences in this time period. We used Twitter. TV Euskadi was the former name of the channel. Now it's the iEuskadi, with about 7,000 tweets. Embajadores de Euskadi was a fan page, Facebook. This is a Facebook account owned by the Destination Management Organization of the Basque Country in Basquetour, with about 2,000 posts. And Euskadi Saboreada, there was a virtual community owned by a tourism agency, but it was about 270 posts, so we discarded this source after this analysis. And once we have decided which will be our data sources, because you have to consider that when we are speaking about the internet, there are many, many different sources. We have to make up some decisions, we have to make some decisions, and we have to decide which will be the sources. After that, you have to start gathering this data. And we use different techniques depending on the sources, because different sources provide different ways to download and to gather, collect the concerning data. In this case, Minube provides an application program interface. We signed it an agreement with them, and we are gathering all the data from Minube. Data from Twitter is extracted using the Twitter for Java API. Facebook is queried through the Facebook Graph API, and the remaining data sources are dumped using web crawling and scrubbing techniques that are developed ad hoc. So with these data gathering processes, we have to make an automatic process to extract, transform, and load all these corpus of texts. And the third step is the most difficult step, is the entity categorization. We need to approach a process of grouping entities into categories. This is the process of entity categorization. And first of all, entities are struck achieving the named entity recognition process. The most important entities in our case, because we are just extracting concepts about the destination, are the nouns, the proper and common nouns. To do sentiment analysis, we need, of course, the adjectives and adverbs. But in this work, mainly we're focused on nouns. And after we get all this data, these recognized entities are classified a list of categories, entities, and number of occurrences. And to achieve this step, the research group, used enhanced and adapted instruments. First of all, an ontology to obtain these categories, and a text mining tool based on WordNet that implements an algorithm for generalized association rules, hierarchy for categorization, and pairs for associations. And after that, these different entities we have to match with the model, with this reference model we used. So, in this reference model I mentioned before, the first dimension is represented by REC, and represents the natural and cultural resources that are attractions. And in this dimension, we include nature, architecture, cultural attractions, and cultural activities. The second dimension represents infrastructures and socioeconomic environment, accommodation, entertainment, shopping, value for price. The third dimension represents social conditions and covers concepts like sustainability, cleaning, security, pollution. And the fourth dimension is the atmosphere, and it reflects the relaxed absence of mass, peace and rest. These concepts that we extract from the different discourses by the perceived and projected image view, we have to match in these different dimensions. 4 minutes? Okay. Let's go to the movement or to the results. The results, the different sources. we have mentioned before, the number of comments, but it's also important to know the language we are analyzing. And the first two are Spanish. Twitter is in Spanish, English, and Euskera, Basque language. Embajadas de Euskadi is the same. The type of discourse is really important because there are different types of discourses depending on the source. Some of them, they have elaborated discourses, and others, due to the constraints of the channel itself, has a more simple discourse. And, of course, the average entities that are the concepts by comment, depending on the type of discourse, the average of entities, is very different as well. The resulting model is shown in this table. So, we show the channel, the image, if it's projected and perceived, and the impacts of the entities, of the recognized entities, belonging to the different dimensions. So here we can see the importance of the first dimension, the natural and cultural resources. In the conclusions, we comment these results. And if we go to put in context with this workshop, if we go to Minube and we put focus in Vizcaya, we know that the main points of interest regarding to this social network, and here we can observe clearly that the museum, the Sosaki, the Oma, the Ukiola, and these cultural and natural resources have a very big and important impact. In the results, the language. Our analysis was achieved for Spanish language mainly, because 70% of the visitors in Euskadi are Spanish speakers. But the projected image in Twitter and Facebook uses the English to translate the original messages in Spanish, and the projected image is fostered by ambassadors who are residents, many of them, and this is why Basque language appears in this coursework. TripAdvisor, this is a network with the most number of comments, but with very little influence and pressure on destination management, but spontaneous user-generated content. Thus, it's important to resource to know the perceived image of the destination. The channel that uses the destination management are mainly the Facebook and Twitter. And before, the type of discourse has conditions a lot the type of discourse. It conditions a lot the type of messages, and the entities are discovered on them. If we follow with the results, the categorization process obtains and results a table of data resource with identified entities, number of occurrences, and the corresponding category. So we identify the entities, we know how is the importance of the, which is the importance of these entities, and the mapping to the categorization. The categorization at the process helps us to match the entity with the dimension of the model. And in conclusions and future lines, TripAdvisor is the social network with the most number of purely user-generated comments and used to measure the perceived image. DMO works mainly with Facebook and Twitter. All the analyzed sources have a major impact on the first dimension concerning natural and cultural resources. And we highlight that cultural attributes of the destinations are really relevant in the discourses. The DMO's efforts are focused on the first dimension, everything related to resources such as nature, architecture, cultural attractions, traditions, and cultural activities. And there is a significant interest in the subcategory of cultural activities. But we consider that the third and fourth dimensions may be taken into account in the communication strategy of the DMO because there's a big lack of it. And within the natural and cultural resources, the gastronomy becomes the most relevant category by the quantity of related terms and concepts. To sum up, the analysis of this type of user-generated content using domain-oriented text mining tools provides a novel approach to understand the destination in the way what people say and perceive and what the destination management communicates. And I think that this is. Thank you very much.